Necessarily represent the views or opinions of the staff,
timing.
Management, or ownership of this station.
Hey, really? Facebook folks.
It's time to get on the right path with Right Path Real Estate Radio with Tom Perry. Get the answer to your question that's keeping you from taking action and succeeding today. Get ready. The guy that will put your fears behind you is on the air now.
Take Mike's
calls
on.
At 713-785-1817. Toll free 877-881-0271. Now here's your host, Tom Perry.
Hey, good morning. Welcome to the show. Welcome to the show, Right Path Real Estate Radio. My name is Tom Perry. I'm the host of the show. Joined live in the studio with my brother from another mother, Mr. Daniel G.
Good morning, everybody. Happy Tuesday. Welcome to the show.
So tonight, have a pretty long day because I've got a webinar, live webinar. And we're doing it as a webinar because one of the things that we find is that we're going after people that are not going to every single networking event.
Yes.
People that want to expose their assets to real estate. And so, you know, we're finding that people, you know, live in Conroe, heck, they could live in Memorial, but let's face it, we've got busy lives nowadays.
Absolutely.
And to show up, you know, for an event to learn how to change your financial future, that takes a big time commitment.
It does.
So we're doing it as a webinar.
We're making it easy.
Yeah, absolutely. Sit in the privacy of your own home or your own office or, you know, wherever. I don't recommend, you know, driving down I-10 in order to, you know, to take a look at this, but, you know, be someplace that you can watch it and then ask questions, you know, get involved.
So you still have the ability to ask questions, which is huge, as opposed to watching something recorded or something like that. Because oftentimes when you're getting new information, you have questions that arise from that.
Yeah.
And you can have that discussion live with Tom and get all the answers to all your questions answered, so you feel comfortable enough to take the next step in this business, in this investment.
Right, absolutely. So our title for today is really it's the common mistakes in thinking. And, you know, something happened yesterday that I wanted to go ahead and address. So, you know, first thing is that you went out and you did, this is not a mistake in thinking, but you went out and did we bought a property, 10 days ago, something like that?
10 or 15 days ago, we did a lease back on it.
Right.
So the seller could get moved out and all that stuff. And we took possession of it on Saturday. I was out of town, of course. So
right.
Yesterday was my first opportunity to get over there and get some pictures and did a live walkthrough.
And from the live walkthrough, got a lot of people that were interested in two things. One is in the property.
Yep.
And then number two, being a part of the Asset Buyers Club.
Yes.
I mean, I think they're hearing about the Asset Buyers Club for the very first time.
Yes.
And that's simply, and by the way, that's growing. I mean, I know we have one person on board there that's actively finding properties. We've got a second one that's going to be completing end of the month.
Yep.
So we're going to grow our capacity in terms of number
Absolutely.
Of deals that we'll be able to find for investors and be able to walk you through and be your representative finding those deals, because I don't think there's a better way to build wealth and income than single-family houses right now. I'd compare it not against pro formas, but against actual performance on almost any other.
My pro forma looks better than
yours. Well, I mean, you know, I've done plenty of pro formas in my life because, you know, I've not started every business that I've done a pro forma on. In fact, I mentioned, my dad called me this morning. He said, I heard you talking about the Volvo thing. And he goes, man, I remember that. He goes, you spent so many hours. I mean, I bet I spent, I don't know, maybe 100 hours on building out this pro forma. It was very, very detailed because, you know, Volvo had done a really good job of discussing all the numbers and what they projected.
Yeah.
And then I just, you know, created a spreadsheet that went out, you know, over the next 5 years. And
which they didn't provide that for you, huh?
No, they didn't. No. And but I also, you know, one of the things about buying a franchise is that they're very strict requirements that a franchise offering circular has to comply with.
Yeah.
And one of those is they have to disclose who they've already sold a franchise to.
Okay.
Whether the franchise is still in business or not. I mean, they have to tell you if anyone's failed or things like that. And so I think that when we were looking, I mean, they were trying to get to like 200 franchisees, and I think they were at like 10 at the time or something.
So they were
like
just getting started. So they hadn't had anybody in long enough to fail.
No, they hadn't. Okay. And they had gone to people that were, who the primary franchisees were in the beginning stages were people that were already customers of theirs prior to the franchise.
Got it.
They were already in the equipment rental business. And so anyhow, so I, you know, in fact, I had gone out and flown to Arkansas and a couple of other places where some of these franchisees were, and had met with them for an entire day. And, you know, they were really good about letting me pick their brain and things like that. And because, you know, we weren't going to be competitors.
Yeah.
They were in Arkansas. We were in Houston.
Of course.
And just kind of give me the insights. And they shared some insights that were some huge red flags. In turn, one of those insights is that you were going to have a really predominantly new equipment mix of, you know, like a newer inventory of all your rental equipment, right? And the real bread and butter of a successful equipment franchise or equipment business is you've got to have quite a bit of pre-owned equipment.
Yeah.
So that you've already, you know, your cost capitalization has already been expended, and your margins go way, way up. And because you're not getting killed by the depreciation. Well, anyhow, so I modeled mathematically this business and saw that, you know, of course, like most businesses, it went cash flow negative the first year, and then it turned around and started going cash flow positive, assuming that you're hitting your sales projections, things like that, and went positive year two and year three, and then about mid, three quarters of the way through year three, it went negative. And then it stayed negative. Yeah. Yeah, I kind of felt it more
there
than
was
I
a
heard.
Yeah, yeah. We had a little pause there. Our building was shaking a little bit. I'm not quite
sure.
Which
kind of a big deal.
Yeah.
We're not in California.
Yeah.
Where earthquakes happen.
This is a pretty solid building.
Right.
I could feel it under my feet, though. The thing was moving.
Yeah, so you know, basically, after year like three and a half to year like three and three quarters, I mean, it turned negative and never recovered.
Yeah.
And as a business model, you know, that's, you know, if economics 101, that's a bad thing.
Yeah, at some point you want to recover, right?
Yeah. So what happened was yesterday you did this Facebook Live of the property, and then, you know, we had a guy reach out to us on Facebook and said, "Hey, I'm really interested in this property. Can somebody, you know, contact me?" And you had in the video
gave
instructions. So
this is what you do if you're interested.
Guy didn't follow that instruction.
He wasn't interested in those.
No, what he did instead is he went straight to Facebook, reached out. Didn't go to our contact information page on Facebook. Didn't call the phone number on there or anything like that. So I reached out to him, and he goes, "Hey man, I'm really interested in this property. What else can you tell me about it?" And you know, honestly, I didn't know which one he was talking about because we've got a couple that we're marketing right now.
It's funny when you run a business how you don't.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. I've not seen all. In fact, I don't even really know where it is.
It's in Cyprus.
Okay. Good. And but I think it's got like a 175 ARV, right? And which is at the upper end of the spectrum for buy and hold.
Yes.
And what I'll tell you is, so in just having this conversation with him, he's a really excited new investor. He works a bunch of hours. He puts in a lot of overtime at his job. He's saved up money. He's lived on less than what he's made. So he's got this bit of a nest egg that he is just itching to put to work. Asset Buyers Club is a program that we have. By the way, I'm interrupted by a question on Facebook. The Asset Buyers Club is a club for our members. It's a member-only club. And to get more information, just email support@rightpathrealestate.com, and in the subject line, just put in Asset Buyers Club, and we get you more information. But we're really designed to it's designed for people that are actively working that don't have time to go out and market. They're not full-time real estate. They're not
just looking to expose their resources.
And
have somebody find the deals for them.
When they see that they can make 30, 35, 40% or more,
yes,
in rates of return in single-family buy and hold, but they say, "Hey, I don't have the time to find the deals," then our Asset Buyers Club is for that person.
Yes.
That because we have licensed agents that will find deals on MLS, and also working with wholesalers, we're developing a reputation among wholesalers as that we take down deals, lots of deals, and we pay a fair price, and it's a win for our Asset Buyer Club
members.
Win
for the wholesaler as well.
Right.
Everybody wins, the seller wins.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
So that's what we've created. But back to this guy. So he's looking to do his first flip. And I said, "Well, first off, you know, the price range, and I see this so much from a brand new investor. What they want to do is they want to find a property for about $65,000 or $70,000. They want to put about $30,000 in the rehab or less, and they want to be able to sell it for like $125,000 to $150,000. Right in that price range. So they want to be below $150,000, and they call that, you know, hey, if I can play small ball,
they feel like they're being safe.
That's a lot more conservative. I really can't, you know, if I'm doing a $400,000 house, I can lose big dollars. Bet big, lose big. Yeah. You know, is what. And so if I bet small, I can't lose very big, right? Yeah. But the reality is that's. That is broken thinking.
Yes.
It doesn't actually work that way. In fact, we'll go in. Well, I'll start with some of the details. So one thing is he wants to use his own money in the deal. And one of the things that we teach at our, we've got a Wealth Through Real Estate Academy coming up. Not this weekend, not this Saturday and Sunday, because that's Easter Sunday. We decided Easter Sunday would be a bad weekend.
Probably.
Yeah, so it's the following Sunday. It's a week from Saturday, this Saturday coming up. And one of the things that we teach about are these are the costs. You've got to understand that there's a cost for selling when you sell the property, and it's about 10%. And I hear immediately people saying, but Tom, I'm an agent, and I can list it myself and make that fee. And so one of the things we talk about is, are you a 10 at doing that? And if you're not a 10 at doing that, you should outsource that. And even if you are doing that, you should still, if you ever want to scale and grow.
If you're a 10 at it, you should get paid to do it.
Right. You should be paid for that over and above being the investor.
Job.
It is a separate job. It's like if you're a chef in a restaurant, you should be paid as being a chef plus owning the restaurant, right? Not just, otherwise, just go be a chef at a restaurant, right? If you want to be an agent. Agent, you know, that's all you want to do, just go be an agent, which is so there's the selling cost, which is about 10%. There's the holding cost, and of course you can lower your holding cost if you put your own money in the deal, but you lose two things. One is if you're not being honest, intellectually honest about your pro forma, then you're not charging the deal the money for the money. And so if you're going to put your own money in there, then your money should be making you money in it, because
if it was somewhere else, it would be
earning. You have other options, right? So, hey, the music says I'm out of time. I'll be back in 4 minutes. I hope you stay tuned, because we want to continue this story about what it is that you can do that is causing you to fail without you realizing it. It's based on broken thinking. So be back in 4 minutes.
Good morning, Christina. Good morning, Ishmael. Good morning, Raymond. Good morning, Victor, Ginger. Hey, Nick, what's going on, brother? My man, Dean. Good morning, Georgina. Good morning, Daniel Vera. Good morning, Anthony Morales. Good morning, David Dabney. Good morning, Patrick Spruce.
Hello,
good morning,
real estate investors. Do you need a lender that moves fast at the speed
morning,
of a jet to fund
Mrs.
your
Mrs. Perry, good
properties?
Morning.
Jet Lending will help
Oscar,
you purchase properties quickly
good morning.
With as little cash out
Brittany,
of pocket as
good
possible.
Morning.
Jet
hey,
Lending
it's Crispy,
also
good
sets
morning.
Up a repair escrow fund to help
hey,
you
Brittany
with
Pounders.
Repair costs.
Long time no speak.
Jet Lending has originated
Maribel,
2,000 loans in Texas.
Do you know Brittany?
Valued at over $250 million.
And her husband, Colin?
Jet Lending will help you evaluate your deals for free and give you feedback on value, cost of repairs.
I know.
Good morning, Brad.
Cross Line and Advocate
fast
for a bunch
friendly,
of years.
Oh, wow.
Source
yeah.
For first-time investors and seasoned professionals. Call 281-872-7800 or email us at info@jetlending.com. Oh, and don't forget about our famous Third Wednesday Super Investor Networking
Meeting. Good morning,
Richard. Lots of fun. Lots of great real estate talk. We'll see you there.
And
time is money in a real estate deal. If your insurance company is slow or non-responsive, you could lose a deal like that. You need a quick turnaround on quotes, binders, and the agency for that is Benchmark Insurance Group of Texas. The team at Benchmark understands the investor
Good
mindset.
Morning, William.
They know what you need and when you need it. It's there for you. Call Houston's leading real estate risk management experts. Benchmark Insurance Group of Texas. 281-569-4353. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com.
Are you looking for an investor-friendly general contractor for your investment property? Then call Fast Track Remodeling at 832-742-9992 or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
Hey, thanks,
Fast
Nick.
Track Remodeling specializes in turnkey remodeling of single-family investment properties. Whether it's a flip rehab or a rental rehab, we manage every aspect of a rehab from start to finish with a highly efficient, standardized process.
Over the last 6 years, Fast Track has completed over 700 projects, which has helped us to create our three keys to success.
Oh, okay.
Use a detailed scope of work so that everything gets done, train and maintain quality crews so it gets done right, and complete the work in a proper order so it gets done fast.
No more managing it yourself. No more doing the work yourself. Fast Track Remodeling really does manage it all.
So give us a call today at 832-742-9992. Again, that's 832-742-9992. Or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
Do you have cracks in your brick?
1 minute.
Doors that stick or sheetrock that's coming apart? Then you may have foundation movement. Due to our expansive soils in the Houston area, it's probably not a question of if you have movement, but when. Call Foundation Check for a truly independent, unbiased foundation evaluation. Foundation Check has been in business since 2009 and has completed over 1,400 evaluations. We're not in the business of repairing foundations or selling you unnecessary peer work, but we are in the business of evaluating your foundation. Our product is designed for house flippers, landlords, or even owner-occupied properties. Each of our files is reviewed by a licensed engineer. Remember to check before every repair. Call 346-702-3825.
10 seconds.
346-702-3825. Or you can reach us online at foundationcheck.com. That's foundationcheck.com.
This is Business 1110.
Hey, welcome back, Right Path Real Estate. We're started a conversation in the previous segment talking about how broken thinking, and here's what the issue is I see this same thought process come up
over and
time
over.
And time and time again, and it's one of those that you go, you know what? All I need to do is put it out there. I'll educate everybody.
Yeah,
and
just then, one fell swoop.
And then we'll be done, and you just get to move on into more advanced and
got
to
do it again tomorrow.
Intermediate and advanced, and what you realize is, hey, there's new people coming in all the time, going to learn that same lesson the hard way. And so, you know, this guy's he saved about $125,000-$130,000.
Yeah.
And which is enough of a nest egg for him to do his own flip in that price range. Well, now here's the bad news about that. One is that he'll never ever be able to do more than one flip at a time.
Yep.
And so your income can go way, way up if you can flip 2, 3, 4, 5 simultaneously. And so it gets you more into a business thinking mode and less in the emotional mode when you're thinking in terms of scaling.
Yes.
So I've never thought in terms of what could I do if I just flip 4 houses in a year.
Yeah.
It's what can I do to flip 4, 5, 6, 7 in a month, yeah. Right? How do we do 10 a month? How do we do 15 a month?
I think that's where most people get started the wrong way. They automatically go into, you know, they're setting their goal too low because, well, you know, I'm not going to have enough time. And the reason they're not going to have the time is because they're doing it wrong, right?
Right.
Well,
they're doing it themselves.
They're doing it themselves. You know, and this guy told you he's working 90 hours a week.
Right.
But he wants to GC the job himself.
Right. He doesn't have, like, one of the things he's told me, and this is when you just listen to people's language. He says, look, I'm too busy working extra overtime and all that. I cannot possibly come to your weekend event to learn how to do it right. Yes. So what I'm going to do instead of hiring a GC, because I'm going to GC it myself. I'm like, have you ever GC'd anything before? No, but I mean, it's like, I just hire the subs, right? I mean, how hard could it be?
Can't be that hard.
And so the errors that you see somebody making, one is that they're competing in a space where mathematically the numbers don't work.
Yes.
And if he were using someone else's money, like a Jet Lending, for example, you know, Johnny and Eddie would prevent him from pulling the trigger on a deal that would be a bad deal.
Yeah, because he'd be trying to flip it, he'd be way overpaying.
Yeah, because if he's in other words, if a property's gonna like we think we're gonna sell this property somewhere between like 135 and 140.
Probably closer to 145 or 150.
Okay, yeah. So at 150, let's say. I mean, it doesn't work. The math just does not work for a buy, fix, and flip guy.
Not even close.
But it works all day long for a buy and hold
guy. Yeah, because it's going to cash flow. They're going to get 15 grand in equity right off the top. You know,
Well, when you look at, if I'm going to flip a house, the first thing I have to budget is, if I'm going to flip a, like we've got a house down in Sugar Land that's going to be like a $400,000 ARV. So what I budget is a $40,000 selling cost.
Yes.
Now, it doesn't make, if I run the math on renting that property, it doesn't cash flow.
Not at all.
Is it going to appreciate? Yes, but I'm going to be negative cash flow. So rather than having, you know, one $400,000 house that rents, I'd rather have, you know, $330,000 rental houses that rent for $1,300 a month versus that $400,000 house. In fact, the guy that's next door to the house that, that we have, that's a rental. Okay. The guy's actually renting the property. I met him this past Sunday, and I think he rents it for like $19,000 or $2,000 a month. So imagine renting, you know, having a $400,000 house that rents for $2,000 a month, which is like 50% of the after repair value of the value of the house, right? Yeah. So
instead of getting 1% in rent, you're only getting 0.5%.
Yeah, it's a 0.5%. So that doesn't work as a rental. So great flip price range, right? And then if you were to go to an Eddie or Johnny and say, hey, I think this property is worth $400,000 and we're buying it for $212,000 and we're putting, you know, $50,000 in it, you know, you're all, I mean, 70% of the $400,000 is $280,000. I mean, we're well below that $280,000 number. And so that's a good flip property. But when you're talking about a 170, 175, you know, ARV, the problem is that if you're using your own money, you don't have that second set of eyes of someone that's really experienced, that's done thousands and thousands of properties to say, no, kind of shake you a little bit and go, hey, your thinking's broken. And, you know, have I flipped properties below $170,000? Yes, but we do a lot of direct marketing.
Yes, you're marketing for those deals yourself.
Right.
And you're buying them at the right price. Right.
But more often than not, we don't like that, because when you understand what the end buyers are, I mean, like we just flipped a property that was a $120,000 ARV, and we prefer to wholesale those houses, really, to buy and hold landlords. Because, you know, when you're flipping that price range, I mean, the people that are buying those properties, they very rarely do they have money to put down on a down payment. So they're
looking for a no down payment program.
Yeah, so
longer, there's more inspections.
And you have an appraisal risk because oftentimes they're giving you above asking price offer and then wanting that extra money. Let's say you're asking $130,000 for a property, they'll give you $135,000, but you're still netting $130,000.
Yeah, because they want the five back to cover closing costs, right?
So now it doesn't have to hit the $130,000 appraisal, which is what you think your ARV is, and it's got to hit a $135,000.
We actually got the first offer came in on that Cypress house this morning.
Yep.
And it's for a retail buyer. They offered four above, and they want that back, right? It's just what you're going to face in that price range, right? And the scary part to me is had that guy called anybody else?
Yes.
Had somebody else been selling this house that didn't have a heart for people and a heart to teach and try to correct, we would have said, hey, great idea.
Yeah.
This is going to work out great for you.
Right, yeah.
Let's get it papered up.
No. Right. They would have, absolutely, all day long.
And I mean, he's going to go because he doesn't have the time to come and learn.
Yeah.
Eventually, somebody's going to sell him that house.
Yes.
And he's going to learn the hard way, and he's going to be out.
Right.
Because he's not going to be willing to go through all that overtime and save all that money and live below his means.
Well, he's going to lose $10,000 or $15,000 on a flip.
Which is going to set him back to square one.
I mean, the market will take advantage of you if you let
absolutely.
It.
Absolutely. It'll chew you up and spit you out. You've got to know what you're doing.
Right. And so that was the first mistake that I see is, one is he's going after the wrong price range. Like, so if you're going to – so hear me, guys. We teach flipping. We teach wholesaling. We teach buy and hold. And there's a price range that each of those should take place at. So on a flip property, we believe that you should be flipping properties that are north of $200,000 unless you're doing direct marketing. I wouldn't be marketing. If you want to flip properties and you're doing direct marketing, I would be marketing for properties north of $200,000 so that you're not competing against the buy and hold guys. Yeah.
Even doing your direct marketing, will you come across those deals? Yes. But 9 times out of 10, you're not the only person they called.
Right.
And the other person they called is doing buy and hold, and they're going to be paying a lot more.
That's correct.
And here's what I find even crazier. Since I put the marketing out last night after the video,
right.
3 or 4 hours later, I was able to get the marketing out.
Right.
Immediately, I mean, I was answering text messages and people were calling my phone until 11:45 last night.
Wow.
And it started first thing this morning at 6:45. Jeez. I was getting text messages.
Wow.
People want this house, right? Mm-hmm. So, I mean, literally, there's 7 showings going on before noon today.
Wow.
But most of it's like you ask the agent, hey, you know, is this a retail buyer? Which this house is very attractive to the retail buyer because it doesn't really need any work, right? It just needs some cleaning up and that sort of thing. And,
right.
But the ones that are representing the investors, it's like, hey, is your guy a buy and hold guy? Oh, no, he wants to flip it.
Right.
It's like, you should know.
But the agents don't.
But they should.
I know, but they don't.
I understand they don't. But
in fact, you know what I find is most agents, they're not out there. You know, you would think that it works like this. And an agent says, hey, you know, let's say you're my investor and I'm your agent. You know, I find this deal and I bring it to you. Hey, Daniel, I found this deal for you. You know, why don't you take a look at it, right? That's the way you would think. That's an agent doing his job.
Yes.
But what I find is that 99% of the time what's happening is you, the investor, you're looking on MLS, you find the deal, and you've got an agent that you work with, and you call me up as an agent, and I'm not looking for you at all, but you're looking, and then you pick up the phone, call me, and say, hey, I found this deal, I want to go take a look at it, will you schedule the appointment for me? And so then, and how do I know that this happens? Well, because you're soon to be an agent, but right now, you know, it asks people to in the agent notes, it asks people to contact you.
Yes.
Now, we don't say that in the general public, but any agent should be able to see that.
Yes.
So what do I normally do? I get a phone call from CSS, which is Centralized Showing Service.
Yeah.
And it says, hey, you know, we're calling about this property. And Centralized Showing Service, they see that the property's not in their system.
Yeah.
Now, they want to get paid because they want to get it added to. And I'm like, and we use Centralized Showing on all of our retail flips.
Retail, of course.
Which, you know, we've got a great, you know, broker through Ivy Partners that and Audra does our retail listings.
Yep.
And she puts them all on Centralized Showing, right? Which is, you know, it's most successful retail listing agents use Centralized Showing.
Yes.
This is not a retail deal.
Nah.
When it's a wholesale deal that's not meant for retail ready. So that means that an agent has done nothing more than get a phone call from their potential investor and then immediately call up Centralized Showing and say, yes, schedule this. And then they don't even read the agent notes. They don't even read the description. They skip. I mean, talk about the epitome of doing the minimum in order to, and it's like, what value is that agent adding to the transaction?
Yeah.
Now, I'm not anti-agent.
I'm not either, but I try to put myself in their shoes, and I think to myself, if I was an agent and I was doing what they're doing to earn a living.
Yes.
And of course, if I'm new, it's going to take me two or three times to realize, hey, my flipping investor is never going to win the offer
on
this range of property.
Right, sure.
So at some point, I've either got to teach Mr. Investor
that,
hey, we got to stop going to look at these. You're never going to get them.
Right.
Or I've got to stop working with that guy because he's making me run around to show him properties he's never going to buy.
Not really making him run around, though, because all he's really doing is making one phone call to Central Showing.
But doesn't he have to be there with him? Okay.
He's supposed to be.
Okay.
According, you've just gone through real estate school,
yes.
So you know that they're supposed to now.
They're supposed to.
But they don't.
Interesting.
Yeah, they don't.
Okay.
I mean, they're supposed to, but they don't. Right. Somebody's supposed to be there.
Somebody's definitely supposed to be there.
But they don't.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, so I guess if you're going to
break the... We're not naming names. We're not throwing anybody under the bus.
If you're going to break the rules, I guess you cannot work as hard.
Right. That's exactly right. So you're listening to Right Path Real Estate Radio. We're going to continue the broken thinking on the other side of the break because I want to tell you how this concluded, and we're really about shifting mindsets so that you can be more successful, so we can have more money in your pocket. You're listening to Right Path Real Estate Radio. We'll be right back.
Hey,
good morning, Richard. Good morning, William. Good morning, Matt Downs.
Ben, what's the deal? Edgar, good morning. Damon, good morning. Andy, good morning.
Do you have cracks in your brick, doors that stick, or sheetrock that's coming apart? Then you may have foundation movement. Due to our expansive soils in the Houston area, it's probably not a question of if you have movement, but when. Call Foundation Check for a truly independent, unbiased foundation evaluation. Foundation Check has been in business since 2009 and has completed over 1,400 evaluations. We're not in the business of repairing foundations or selling you unnecessary peer work, but we are in the business of evaluating your foundation. Our product is designed for house flippers, landlords, or even owner-occupied properties. Each of our files is reviewed by a licensed engineer. Remember to check before every repair. Call 346-702-3825. That's 346-702-3825. Or you can reach us online at foundationcheck.com. That's foundationcheck.com.
I think there's four appointments scheduled for 9:30.
Hello, real estate investors. Do you need a lender that moves fast at the speed of a jet to fund your investment properties? Jet Lending will help you purchase properties quickly with as little cash out of pocket as possible. Jet Lending also sets up a repair escrow fund to help you with repair costs. Jet Lending has originated over 2,000 loans in Texas valued at over $250 million. Jet Lending will help you evaluate your deals for free and give you feedback on value, cost of repairs, and potential loan amount. Jet Lending is your fast and friendly hard money source for first-time investors and seasoned professionals. Call 281-872-7800 or email us at info@jetlending.com. Oh, and don't forget about our famous Third Wednesday Super Investor Networking Meeting. Lots of fun, lots of great real estate talk. We'll see you there.
Time is money in a real estate deal. If your insurance company is slow or non-responsive, you could lose a deal like that. You need a quick turnaround on quotes or binders? The agency for that is Benchmark Insurance Group of Texas. The team at Benchmark understands the investor mindset. They know what you need and when you need it. We're here for you. Are you a rehabber, wholesaler, buy and hold, or flipper? Bundling your properties on a single policy will help save time and money. Benchmark has been in business for over 10 years, and we insure over 30,000 properties. Contact Benchmark about our exclusive investor package. Call us and let us show you what we can do for you.
Morning, this is Daniel.
281-569-4353. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com. That's benchmarkbroker.com.
Just text me your name and your public ID. 281-569-4353.
Or online at benchmarkbroker.com.
1 minute.
Are you looking for an investor-friendly general contractor for your investment property? Then call Fast Track Remodeling at 832-742-9992 or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
Fast Track Remodeling specializes in turnkey remodeling of single-family investment properties. Whether it's a flip rehab or a rental rehab, we manage every aspect of a rehab from start to finish with a highly efficient, standardized process.
Over the last 6 years, Fast Track has completed over 700 projects, which has helped us to create our three keys to success. Use a detailed scope of work so that everything gets done, train and maintain quality crews so it gets done right, and complete the work in a proper order so it gets done fast.
No more managing it yourself, no more doing the work yourself. Fast Track Remodeling really does manage it all.
So give us a call today at 832-742-9992. Again, that's 832-742-9992, or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
This is Business 1110.
Mic's on.
Hey, welcome back. Right Path Real Estate Radio. We're doing real estate during the radio show.
Yes, we are.
You're taking phone calls from agents. Yeah.
You got another one coming in right now.
Right. And I'm doing I've actually got a fourplex that I'm taking down by the middle of next month at the latest.
Handling a rehab we've got going right now.
Right. That's exactly right. And then the guy's asked, so he called during the break and he's asking, what radio station are you on? Cuz I'm like, "Hey, in the middle of a radio show."
Let's go ahead and get him tuned in. Hey, good morning, Robert.
Right,
good morning,
exactly.
Clay.
So we're going back to talking about, some of the mental mistakes that people make. One is I see that when people are starting to flip, they want to flip in the same space. When you look at, as a flip investor, you have to worry about, who am I competing against? Now, I don't mind competing with any other flip investor out there, right? I mean, I'm head to head. I don't mind competing with any other flip investor. What I don't want to do is compete against a retail end user owner.
Absolutely
occupant.
Not.
I mean, because if I ever walk into a property, I'm looking around and going, man, this property is ready to be listed. I mean, it's like, what's going on? Oh, well, I figured I'd give you a deal, So what'll typically happen is you'll get a house in Kingwood, for example, and let's say it's worth $350,000 and it's all fixed up. And so we all know that the selling cost on that's about $35,000, about 3% for the buyer's agent, about 3% for a seller's agent. it's 2% for closing costs. It's another 2% for what we call negotiation after the sale. So total that up, and I went through those numbers kind of fast because numbers don't make for really great radio.
Yeah.
And if you want to learn more about that, we spend two full days going through the math and the vocabulary and all that kind of stuff in our Wealth Through Real Estate Academy. So what will happen is the guy, you know, have his house at 350. You know, he knows that if he sells it retail, he'll get 350 for it. But if he knows that he doesn't stick 350 in his pocket, he'll stick about 315 in his pocket. So sometimes what they'll say is, well, you know, my house is worth 350.
I'll give it to you for 320.
317.5. Yeah. Cut you a deal. You know, you can make a quick 10 or 15. Just move on down the road. Yeah. You know, you sell it for 380. You know, it's like, hey, bada bing, bada boom. I mean,
people fall for it.
Well, and what happens is they don't know the math, right? Yeah. And you'll learn that math pretty quickly. So I walk in going, oh my gosh, this is a retail ready house. Yeah. I'm not creating value. You have to understand the value that we create in the marketplace is we're providing liquidity to a property that most people don't want to buy in the condition that it's in, right? So when you see the hoarder houses or houses that smell like, you know, animals or, you know, I mean, that have foundation issues or roof issues or plumbing issues, most retail buyers,
they won't touch it.
They're very, very picky on those kind of things. So interacting with my brother Jeff also, and we've got a property down in Sugarland. Yeah. And this is another mistake that I see that rookie investors make is that they have a tendency to want to get emotionally involved in the property, and you've really got to study what it is that that your comps say. So we've got this property in Sugar Land, and it's going to have about a $400,000 ARV. And when I study the comps, you know, I prefer to have hard surfaces in like the dining room or in a study or places like that. And so, you know, when I look at all the comps, I don't see a single person that has done, like the builder, when they built the house brand new, you know, probably 30-something years ago, they were putting carpet in the dining room. They were putting carpet in the study. They were putting tile in the kitchen, the utility room, that little, you know, and in the entryway, right?
Yep.
And they were even putting carpet in the den area.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, like even in the den. And so what we've decided to do is we're replacing the tile, giving it a more updated tile look. And then we're going to go with a glued-down engineered hardwood in the den area.
Yeah.
But I'm like, I don't see that I get it. It's about $2,300 more. $2,256 is the difference to go that same hardwood. I don't think I'll get an extra $3,000 on this. I mean, I think I'm going to get $395 whether I put carpet in or whether I put engineered hardwood. And I think that because of the location and how highly desirable the area is, I don't think I can get $450.
Yeah.
I don't think I can get $4. I mean, I might be able to get $425 because I see about a 2,800 square foot house going. It just went pending after like 8 days on market at $395, and ours is about a 3,300 square foot house.
Okay.
That's gonna. I haven't seen one with an updated bathroom, and we've updated the master bathroom. Not only the master, but the Jack and Jill upstairs,
nice.
plus the other bathroom.
So upstairs. You don't think replacing that floor pushes it any higher towards the top of the market?
I don't think it does.
Okay.
I think
if you were keeping that house, would you spend the extra $2,200 if it was a rental?
No, well, first I wouldn't want to rent a $400,000 house.
I understand, but let's say it was in a different price range, and you were doing carpet versus hardwood
floor.
So I
don't like carpet in it, so we don't do any carpet at all in our rentals.
Okay.
Yeah. In fact, what I prefer to do is the vinyl plank that looks like wood.
Yeah.
In the bedrooms and now that I've not always felt this way. When I first started back in 2010, I liked tile in all the common areas, and I liked carpet in the bedrooms because I personally like stepping out onto carpet, you know.
Yeah.
Like, but what I realize now, having worked with literally, you know, thousands of landlords.
Yes.
And between Fast Track and then also Houston House Buyers and Right Path. And yeah, he's saying people don't like carpet in the dining, and I would agree with that.
Absolutely.
I don't like carpet in the dining.
I definitely don't.
However, every single comp that I've got, like, in fact, when I look at the comps that are on the market right now, they all have carpet in the dining room.
Okay.
So it's not preventing it from selling.
Yeah.
And
if they don't like carpet in the dining, they always have the option to change it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's exactly right. Or even the same thing. I mean, do you like carpet in a study?
I wouldn't.
You wouldn't?
I wouldn't. I'm to the point now, I don't like carpet at all.
Yeah.
I just would rather not have it. Now, I could see if you're trying to make the study quiet and comfortable, you know, maybe you would.
Yeah.
But
so again, somebody that has not,
somebody didn't read the notes,
not read the agent notes.
Yeah.
So I'm just gonna ask: is your client an investor or a retail buyer? Yeah. And again,
and they're calling.
Yeah. Different person calling.
I love it. I love it when things are on fire.
So back to somebody that's that is really a brand new investor. So yeah. One is we think that you buy and hold investors are operating from a price point of about $175,000 a door and below, all the way down to we don't really like properties below about $50,000 to $70,000 as an all in price. Unless and we only like the $50,000 to $75,000 price range if you're going in as a strategy of Section 8 housing.
Yeah.
And because there is a marketplace for that, but so between, let's call it 50 to 75 on the low end, up to 175. That's your buy and hold space.
Yep.
Flip it space, I think, is $200,000 in north.
Yes.
And I would say in Houston, Texas, I like properties that are below about $500,000. Will we flip properties above that? Yeah, but we have to really look at what's the days on market, because north of $500,000, it's really, that's been a slow market space
now. Even slower. You know, as you move forward, it anything above 500,000, your buyer pool is a lot more limited.
Right.
Right. And same thing when you get below 100. Now, a lot of people say, well, what about between 175 and 200? I keep saying, you say up to 175 and then on flipping, you start at 200, but you're skipping that whole area between 175 and 200.
Right.
So for those of you that are wondering that, you've got to understand that we like to call that, you know, no man's land.
Right,
you can go either way.
Yeah, you can.
Now, when do you decide to go buy and hold, and when do you decide to go flip?
Yeah, you have to look at rental rates.
You have to look at rental rates.
Right, yeah.
If the rental rates on a $180,000 house are $1,500, $1,450, then you want to go. You want to be flipping in that neighborhood. If they're $1,800, $1,900, $2,000, then it's still okay to keep that as a buy and hold, because that'll still cash flow for you.
Right.
So we talk a lot about people not wanting to do the $250,000, $350,000 houses because they feel like there's a lot more opportunity for them to make a mistake there that's going to cost them more money than if they're doing a $150,000 house. Now, what I don't think they realize is the value of the asset is the value of the asset.
Right.
Right? So if you screw up on a $400,000 house,
2 minutes.
You're going to be able to recoup a certain amount of your money selling it even as is, just like if you were doing a $150,000 house.
Right.
But what they don't realize is very often you can have an oops, and that usually is going to happen in the construction.
Yes.
Right?
Right.
Now, if I have a $10,000 oops on a $400,000 house,
yep,
that's going to eat up 25% of my projected 10% profit.
Right.
Right? If I was planning on making $40,000, I had a $10,000 oops, now I'm out. Now I'm only going to make 30. I can still survive on that.
Yes.
Now, if I have that exact same oops on a $120,000 house, when I was only going to make 12 or 15 grand, that $10,000 oops completely wipes you out.
Yes.
So if you think about it correctly,
right,
it's safer,
yes,
to do the higher valued houses than it is.
If you believe in math.
If you believe in math, which, you know, most parents are strict,
yeah,
and they make their kids go to math every day.
1 minute.
Yeah. Dave Ramsey, he says that everyone should learn a second language, preferably math.
Preferably math.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
And
so if you take
my
the time.
My parents were super strict.
They made you go every day, right?
Every day.
Yeah.
And I had to take math. I mean, every school day. I mean, they didn't make me take math.
Not
Saturday
on Saturday
and Sunday.
Sundays.
But yeah. In fact, in eighth grade, I went to a military school, and I was the school's math top student.
Okay.
And yeah.
Not a lot of bright math minds.
Not
in
a lot
the
of Marine Corps
military.
math. Yeah. The bucket was low.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. It was not. It was a shallow pool.
There you go.
Yeah. So anyhow, but you know, what I love about the math in real estate is it's not complicated.
It's
math.
Not.
It's not.
It's really, really simple math.
But the thinking is not necessarily intuitive. The music says I'm out of time. I've got this is the last break before our last 4 minute segment. We'll be back in 4 minutes. Stay tuned.
Hey, good morning, Robert. Good morning, David. Good morning, George. Good morning, Yanni. Good morning, Che.
Time is money in a real estate
dialogue.
If your insurance company is slow or non-responsive, you could lose a deal like that. You need a quick turnaround on quotes or binders.
Okay.
The agency for that is Benchmark Insurance Group.
Great tech sell too.
The team at Benchmark understands the investor mindset. They know what you need and when you need it. We're here for you. Are you a rehabber, wholesaler, buy and hold, or flipper? Bundling your properties on a single policy will help save time and money. Benchmark has been in business for over 10 years, and we insure over 30,000 properties.
Did we get rid of the smell?
Contact Benchmark about our exclusive investor package.
He said they were there.
Call us and let us show you what we can do for you.
Night about 6:30 or
7.
Because I have people that wanted to go see it last night.
281-569-4355.
Can we just wait till tomorrow?
Or online at benchmarkbroker.com.
You don't?
That's benchmarkbroker.com. That's
281-569-4355.
Or online at benchmarkbroker.com.
Because I'm that flat tire guy, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Are you looking for an investor-friendly general contractor for your investment property? Then call Fast Track Remodeling at 832-742-9992 or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
Fast Track Remodeling specializes in turnkey remodeling of single-family investment properties. Whether it's a flip rehab or a rental rehab, we manage every aspect of a rehab from start to finish with a highly efficient, standardized process.
Over the last 6 years, Fast Track has completed over 700 projects, which has helped us to create our three keys to success. Use a detailed scope of work so that everything gets done, train and maintain quality crews so it gets done right, and complete the work in a proper order so it gets done fast.
No more managing it yourself.
Just to leave
no more
me a
doing
message
the work
so
yourself.
I can call her back.
Fast Track Remodeling really does manage it all.
So give us a call today at 832-742-9992.
Again,
that's 832-742-9992. Or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
Why do I expect you to be awake and call me back?
Selecting a foundation
why you
company
call me?
30 seconds.
For repair is a lot like a game of chance. You simply don't
People
know what you're going to get. The foundation repair industry as a whole doesn't carry a license, nor is it regulated. However, Foundation Check utilizes professional engineers to review all of our files to give you the best foundation analysis in today's market.
Remember 10 seconds.
To check before every repair. Call 346-702-3825 or you can reach us online at foundationcheck.com.
This is Business 1110.
Mic's on.
Hey, welcome back. Right Path Real Estate Radio, 713-780. Oh, forget it. Don't call.
You're not going to call anyone.
You know what I want to tell you about is that I'm going to do a live webinar tomorrow. No, excuse me.
Tonight.
Tonight at 7 o'clock. Go to rightpathrealestate.com. That's Right Path, RightPath.
You've got 9 hours to clear your calendar.
Yeah.
You can do it.
Yeah. So at 7 o'clock tonight, it's going to be about, the presentation is about 40 minutes.
Yep.
And then I open it up to questions. You know, it's pretty self-explanatory. I have to admit, the few times that I've done it, I've not had that many questions.
Yeah.
Because people are like, I almost feel like that it's almost a mic drop moment at the end, you know, where people are just like, I feel like their mouth is just kind of gaping open with like, oh my God, I never considered it like that, right? So that's going to be at 7 o'clock tonight, and it is totally free to attend. And then tomorrow night. I mean, one of the best economists talking about real estate. I mean, he was the head of the Texas A&M Real Estate Research Center for, gosh, a bunch of years. I want to say close to 20 years.
Yeah.
And he's since retired, but he speaks across the country about the economics of real estate. And a very entertaining economics speaker. Which is, you know, kind of an oxymoron.
It is.
But he's the exception to that. So Dr. Dotzauer, he's going to be at the Redneck Country Club tomorrow night. And if you'd like to get free tickets to go to that, send an email to support at Right Path Real Estate and just say Dr. Dotzauer. And don't worry about spelling it correctly. Just in the subject line, just put in Dr. Dotzauer, and we can get you free tickets. But it's going to be standing room only.
It is definitely going to be standing room
only.
And
what I can tell you is it's free food, it's free beverages.
Yep.
It's at the Redneck Country Club down in Stafford. But you're going to need to have pre-registered in order to get in the door because it's going to pack out. And I have a feeling this may be the very first time that due to fire code regulations that they may have to limit how many people can be inside. But it's definitely an event that you don't want to miss. And again, that's tomorrow night. And then And then we're not having a base camp this Thursday because it's Monday, Thursday.
Yeah.
And then also a Good Friday, and then we're going to have Easter. And then next week we have our case study.
We do. And it's going to be a great case study. I'm so excited about it.
Yeah, Joe is going to be sharing his story, and it's a very duplicatable. You know, sometimes I look at a Jeff Bezos and you go, oh my God, he did amazing things with his business, and like, what, you can't duplicate that.
You can't.
I mean, you're not going to go do that. But when you hear Joe's story and you just see how, you know, he bought his first rental property just 7 years ago, and that over $100,000 of equity appreciation in the last 7 years. And you go, you know what? If you did 10 of those, you've made $1 million in seven years. And you're like, that's duplicatable.
It is.
I mean, and that's what it is that we want to help you to do. And it's not a pie in the sky pro forma. It's not. And in fact, if you plug that in, if you were to come to two events over the next week, it could change your life. And that's seeing Dr. Dotzauer and seeing his economic forecast for what he thinks appreciation is going to be in the single family real estate space. And then you add that to our case study next Thursday, and you see somebody that's actually done it and wants to help you do the same thing. It's like, come on in, the water's fine.
Absolutely.
You know, like, let's show you how to do that. So all you need to do is go to rightpathrealestate.com, register for both of those events. You can't register for the event tomorrow night on our site, but
but you shoot me an email and we'll get you what you need to get there.
We'll get you a link over there to support it. Just support it, Right Path Real Estate. Just say Dr. Dotzauer and Dr. Dots. Yeah, so I'll be there tomorrow night. Looking forward to it. I'll also be live on the webinar tonight. So just to wrap up, this guy that I was talking to yesterday, I mean, it was interesting. I felt like I wanted to shake this guy because he really didn't want to hear what it is that I was. I'm looking out for his best interest in spite of him. You could almost hear, but I want to. And it's like, no, you don't know what you don't know.
Yeah.
And just saying that you want to doesn't make it. But you don't understand. I've got the cash to do it. I'm like, yeah, but you don't understand. That's not in your favor.
Yeah.
I'm looking out for you because I care. It's like I really want people. I have this abundance mindset that if you make money on your first deal, then you'll do another deal and then another deal. And I want to help you do that.
As much as we want to obviously sell that house, right?
Yeah.
We know we'll sell it.
Yeah, of course.
But we don't want to sell it to somebody that's going to ruin them.
Right.
And even though it's very likely that somebody else is going to.
Yeah.
And chances are we're not going to get that guy the road on another house. We're not going to be able to sell him something in the future because somebody's going to let him pull the trigger.
Right.
And if he's not willing to open his mind to hear the right way, to take some guidance, to take some coaching, which, you know, a lot of people aren't. And that's one of the things we talk about at our two-day academy. You know, the first thing you have to do is you've got to give us permission to be your coach.
Yep. Because not your cheerleader.
If you won't do that, you're wasting your time. You're wasting our time. Right?
Yeah.
In 30 seconds.
Not everybody has that mindset.
No.
Unfortunately.
Don't. Yeah. So we see that people are picking the wrong price range. People are wanting to use their own money. People are not knowing the cost correctly. So those are some of the biggest mistakes that we see over and over and over again. And if you want to fix that, just plan on coming to the weekend. It's our Wealth Through Real Estate Academy. It's not this weekend, but next weekend. So, guys, today has been Tuesday. We've had a great day. Good show.
Absolutely.
Daniel G., thanks
Wonderful
for being
show.
In the house.
Thanks,
I'll
everybody.
Be back tomorrow. We love you guys. Bye-bye.
You've been listening to Right Path Real Estate Radio. Find Tom at rightpathrealestate.com. You can put the fear behind you and listen every day from 9 to 10 a.m. on Business 1110 KTEK.